Today, let us learn about diffusion. The intermixing of particles of different types of matter on their own is called diffusion. In the context of the properties of particles of matter, we have discussed that particles are continuously moving. We have seen certain example, the smell of hot food reaching you, the smell of incense stick when it is lighted, again a drop of ink when it is added to water. All these are examples of diffusion. Diffusion of one solid into another solid in general does not occur. This is because of the very close packing of the particles in the solid state, and they are very strongly attracted. The solid does not move from their positions. But solid, liquid and gases can diffuse easily into liquids because liquids have more freedom of movement. And when we take the case of gases, they undergo diffusion rapidly. And as you know that there are large space between the particles and they have very least force of attraction. And so the movement of gaseous particles are very fast. Now let us see some examples of diffusion. Solid in liquid. Example, salt solution, sugar solution, copper sulfate solution, you could say, where here the salt or sugar is solid and it is mixed with water, that is being liquid state, to form the solution. Let us come to liquid in liquid diffusion. We can see vinegar in water, both are in the liquid state. Alcohol in water, again milk mixed with water, all these are in liquid state. Now when we speak about gas in liquid, we can take the example of our aquatic animals taking this dissolved oxygen for the survival, for breathing. So oxygen is dissolved in water, so the gas in liquid. Again, the soft drinks, the soda water which you drink, carbon dioxide which is being a gas is dissolved in water, that is in the liquid state. Now the next topic, why gases exert pressure? You know that gases exert pressure, which can be measured in atmosphere. The units I'm speaking about, which can be measured in Pascal, you might have learned in physics and all, but now we want to know how they exert pressure. As we know, gaseous particles are moving very fast, and in this random movement, you can see the figure, the random motion is clearly seen there. The particles hit each other and also the walls of the container. Because of these collisions, the particles of gas is exerting a force on the walls of the container. This force exerted per unit area on the walls of the container, we can call it to be pressure. So the definition is very clear to you. The force exerted per unit area on the walls of the container is called pressure. A very simple example, we are blowing a balloon. The balloon is inflated. Why? Because the air particles inside the balloon collide with the walls of the balloon and exert a force, and that force is called pressure, and thereby balloon is inflated.